is that any work that falls into one of those five categories and published or broadcast from January to December of a particular year, namely 2018, all the work that has been published in newspapers and magazines and that has been broadcast over radio and telecast on television or written in what, photographs and online, they will qualify. But this work has to appear in the global media outside of South Asian region. And we will have a jury which will select the best entries. Normally, it will be till the end of February every year that we will be receiving entries. But this year we are starting a bit late, therefore we are accepting entries up to 15th of March. We are hoping to have the award ceremony around the 23rd of March. So this is the first lot. Then we will continue to do this in future. As we go forward, we may be expanding the categories, maybe, Lifetime Achievement Award and things like that we'll be picking. So let us see how it goes. All our members, because Professor Samantha came here some time ago and we ran a program called An Evening with Professor Achyuta Samantha. We showed a film about his work and everything, and his institutions, the KIIT attracts students from 50 countries, and the KISS, that is Kalinga Institute for Social Studies, educates 27,000 tribal children, and that is the largest school of its kind in the whole world. And they accept children from age 4, and they give them free food, free education, free clothing and everything. It goes on up to class 12, which is a very, very rare kind of thing. First class. Anyway, I will request Dr. Samantha to tell us something about this. I want to introduce my friend Raghu Rai. He has very graciously agreed to join the jury. I don't need to introduce him because he is a very well-known personality. And my good friend Jeffrey Gettman is a South Asia Bureau Chief of the New York Times, himself a winner of the Pulitzer Prize. And when we requested him to come for this event, he readily came, and he's joining us. I request Dr. Samantha to tell us something about the two institutions you are running, and how you accepted our invitation to fund this awards program for the next 5 years, Dr. Samantha.
So, good evening, everybody present here. I am Hankar Narayanji, president of this FCC, also respected Zachary and also respected Raghu Rai Singh. All the other respected journal friends present here at this FCC assembly. So, thank you very much, as Hankar Narayanji. Giving me an opportunity to speak to all of you. At the outset, I express my thanks and gratitude to him, the president of this FCC, for having association with our organization, Kate and Kiss, at Bhubaneswar. We are very much happy to be associated with FCC under his presidency. And also, we are happy to be part of this Kalinga FCC Award in five streams in the coming 5 years. So we are very much happy, and I'm not also at the same time. As Some of you must be knowing about the activities we have been doing for the last 27 years, since 92-93. And as Venkat Narayanji himself has visited our place, and he's a very nice person. Because I am always happy to be associated with the good persons. That's my good quality. Because I myself is a very good person. Yeah. I claim always. I don't boast myself, but I always claim I am a very good person with a good soul. And people, those who know me, they love me because I am a good person. I am not the founder of Cricket Keys, member of parliament. All these things, these are all one side. But to get a good person in this present society is very difficult, next to impossible. One can get it in the moon, but one cannot get a good person, so I used to speak. Because why I am telling a good person, just I will take 2 minutes to tell you, why he loves me or entire world loves me or my noble work. Definitely I am the founder of these two organizations. It has been my passion since my childhood to eradicate poverty and hunger through education, which has become the worldwide, starting from UN, up to the Prime Minister of India, everybody, eradication of poverty and hunger through education. I have been doing for the last 27 years, relentlessly, and because of my own passion. How my own passion, because when I know what is poverty and what is hunger, how this poverty, hunger kills everything. As I myself lost my father when I was only 4 years old, and with 7 brothers and sisters and widow mother, brought up in the midst of severe poverty in one remote village of Odisha. And you can think of 1970, what was Odisha and what was the condition. And the poverty I described in 2 sentences, that we all are so poor, we are not getting even 1 square meal in 2 days, my mother and a second pair of sari to change up to back. So after experiencing that type of poverty since my childhood at the age of 4, and becoming the completely self-made person because of the God's grace, and I was doing my lectureship job and I started both the organizations, Keys and Keys, with only 5,000 rupees in my pocket in Food Entered House in Bhubaneswar in 92-93. It was my prayer to Almighty, if the growth of KIT takes place, the growth of KIS automatically takes place. KIT is one of the most promising professional university in India and beyond India. As rightly told by him, with 30,000 students at present, pursuing the professional course including medicine from the 50 countries and from Pan-India. And my passion is to eradicate poverty. I started the Kalinga School of Social Science with 125 tribal children. Now it has become the beauty of the entire world revolution and the most successful model. With 15,000 poor tribal children have been taken care of, 15,000 already passed out, 27,000 already in the campus. From the KG to PG, from the age group 5 of KG to 25, another 10,000 in 10 satellite campus of KIS in 10 districts of Odisha. And it is fully free, fully residential. And we are not getting any funds from government or any corporates or any etc. I have been running this KIS with the help of the entire stakeholder of KIS. As I lived a simple life becoming the bachelor's in a rented house. So my only passion to eradicate poverty and hunger. That's why I should stop myself here. I am really a good person with a good soul. I always play. Because I always love to be associated with the good persons. When I saw or met as Venkat Narayanji, I found he is a pretty senior to me in all aspects. So I thought I should be associated with him. I am very much happy that we are associated with him. So thank you very much for this very good things coming in at CCR. We will be with you. And my special thanks to Mr. Jeffrey and also the great photographer Raghuraji. I am very much honored to be with you. And thank you very much our all the journalist friends. And for the kind introduction, I have been always the great fan of the journalist. My one close associate Dipan Rath is also sitting here. The also journalist like you from Odisha. And also Mr. Dikhit is also present here from Odisha. And I also, though I am a good educational social activist, I have a tremendous contribution in art, literature, culture, feeling, and many other things. Really tremendous contribution. And also I am one TV channel known as Kalinga TV, one electronic media TV channel for the last 4 years. And we achieved, as you know, your friend is also here. And running also very good, two popular magazines, of course, all these things in Odisha and Odia. So I am partly also in your line with School of Mass Communication, under one also the KIT University, besides Philip Fashion and many other things. So once again, thank you very much, and thanks to S. Venkat Narayan ji for your all good work. Thank you.
Thank you, Archibald. I just wanted to announce that Sir Mark Tully will be on the jury, and Francois Gauthier is a French journalist who has been living in India for more than 25 years. He is also will be on the jury. And the Reuters South Asia Bureau Chief Martin is also agreed to be on the jury. And then Raghu is there. Jeffrey, if you have the time, I would like you to, because you are a Pulitzer Prize winner, so it would be nice to have somebody like you on there. And before we sign the MOU, there is a press release we have prepared, and it is available. While leaving, you can collect it. All the information and all that we have spoken will be available. May I now request Raghu Rai to say a few words on this occasion? Thank you, Venkat Bhaiya, for inviting me here as part of the jury, and especially Achyutji, kya baat hai, the kind of work you have done, God bless you, and that you associated with SCC, which is a wonderful thing, because in India, we don't have any such awards for young journalists, writers, photographers, and this will take them a long way in creating something meaningful and powerful. Because I think almost all newspapers, photography, photojournalism has become just infotainment kind of nonsense. And you know, even the magazines, they are giving more portraits on their covers as if there is no journalistic happening in, you know, around the world or in our own country. I mean, the shape of photojournalism is almost dying with digital technology, whereas it should be flourishing, because digital technology is so amazing, the freedom it gives you, the magic moments you can capture at any time of the day. But may I also suggest that, you know, it should not only be about published work, because many photographers who cannot, you know, convince the editors or tell the desk, you know, what is good in terms of visual imagery of the event, and the pictures are not published in the newspaper or magazines at times. So, you know, if it's news related, an important aspect of our daily life or political or social cultural life, we should not ignore those images, because I have faced this when I was young, and the man on the desk won't understand, you know, and you have to fight for it. So before you become anybody established, you have to go through this hell where, you see, once Illustrated Weekly did a cover story on me, and Pritish Nandi was the editor, and he said, Raghu, give us some strong line, you know, to put it on the cover. I said, yes. I said, most educated people and editors are visually literate people. Now, this visual illiteracy is prevalent because it's like listening to classical music and say, what the hell is going on? But when you tune in over the years, then you understand the journey of classical music. Similarly, the visual experience is not that simple black and white picture that this is it and that's over. The inner details, the vibrations, the feelings that get captured, the aura of the person or the madness of a situation can be captured in so many different ways. And many people, unless your eye is visually trained over the years, you know, now there are several people, photographers who are called picture editors, but their understanding of images is so little, so poor, and so much gets left out. So it's very important that, please, I request that for at least for Photojournalist of the Year, you should allow someone whose work has not been published but was so important, a document of that moment which cannot be ignored. This will be my request, and it's a great thing that is happening with FCC and Chitradi. It's wonderful. I love to be a part of this. Thank you so much. May I invite Jeffrey to say a few words on the delegation?
Thanks everybody for coming tonight. I think it's really wonderful to start something new. How many times do you get to start for the first time something big, important, and positive, and encouraging like this? I'd like to thank you for your generosity and believing in journalism. There's so many people these days that put us under assault. There's never been a harder time to be a journalist in contemporary times. You know, we're taking it from all directions. We get trolled on social media, our governments give us problems, our readers, their passions and their angers and their disrespect is often, fired toward us. And so it's really nice that somebody believes in the value of journalism. Like, we have to celebrate that. And one thing I just like to add is, you shouldn't go into journalism to win awards. You know, the award is kind of like the cherry on top. You should be doing this because you love the work. You believe in making a difference. You're using the power of the press and enjoying the freedoms that we have in a democracy. However challenged it is, we're so much freer in this room than most people are around the world, even especially in this part of the world. They couldn't write the things that we write. They couldn't take on the powers that be that we do. And granted, there's problems, but we still have an enormous amount of power. And that's why you should be a journalist. That to do that for good, and to enjoy the adventure, to go out into the field and witness history, or even small moments with people whose stories you want to tell. You give them a voice. You walk in their shoes for a few minutes. You get an opportunity to live so many different lives as a journalist, right? I mean, the work you've done in the field, you've seen things that are several lifetimes full of experiences. And your excuse was you had a camera with you, but it was really interesting even if you hadn't had a camera with you. So I'm really grateful that we're doing this with awards, but I would just want people to understand that you shouldn't do it for the award. This is just a way to recognize good work, to give somebody a pat on the back, and to celebrate what we're all doing. And that's just, now more than ever, really important. Thank you.
Thanks, Jeffrey. We will now sign the Memorandum of Understanding between Kalinga Institutions and the FCC. Donate them to the FCC library. So if you want to see these pictures, you're most welcome to come and visit them. I request Raghu to formally hand over the book.
One is a book about Dalai Lama, whom he has been covering for the last, since 1975. Beautiful pictures. The second one is 50 years of photographs by Raghu Rai. this should be a text within our community, that is all over the world should see. Thank you very much, Raghu. We're grateful. You have been very kind. You gave earlier also some books. Thank you so much. Yeah, Raja, you wanted to
show the prayer of the
king. Please come. We have a friend from People's Daily, Chinese journal. Please come and come in. This is a journalist from China, People's Daily.
Namaste.
Kalimba Institute of Social Sciences, Case International, India, the world's largest clinically residential educational institute and home for 25,000 poorest of the poor tribal children, including 15,000 girls, providing comprehensive and complete education from kindergarten to post-graduation with vocational and all-round skills empowerment. KISS has been fulfilling the Millennium Development Goals and the SDGs of the United Nations Organization, transforming tax consumers into taxpayers, creating social assets and agents of change. KISS is a unique educational initiative for social transformation and peace. Evening, please join us for a cup of tea and some pakoras and stuff like that. Thank you.